Hogging.
I believe I found the knob from the stolen cane, which I succeeded in putting back together.
That's the one. And yet I cannot give it to you, Doctor. I will only return it to the police, and only if there is an official complaint against me.
Would there be a way to convince you to give me the cane?
Find me a dozen solid, adjustable harnesses for wooden leg prostheses, and it's yours, Doctor.
Goodbye, Dr. Gibbons.
Until we meet again, my dear colleague.
It was that shop. Is it open? Oh, it is.
There's nobody here. How very odd. I say, these things look like harnesses. Oh my, they are noisy. Good evening, sir. Pardon the interruption. The door was open. I didn't think that I would find anyone working at this hour.
Good evening, sir. I didn't hear you come in.
Say, those things that made noise, they are really harnesses, aren't they?
Yes, horse harnesses. But I must tell you, sir, that the store is normally closed at this hour. That is why I've asked you to return tomorrow.
I didn't come about my shoes. I came to speak of a cobbler, perhaps one of your former employees, a man with very particular habits.
You aren't with the police by any chance. I'm sorry, but I do not want to speak of anything but shoes with you.
I am not a policeman. I am Dr. Watson. It's Mr. Finlay who told me that you might be in a position to inform me.
Ah, that Mr. Finlay is a very brave man. And if he sent you, then you must certainly be a worthy man also. So, Doctor, who is this cobbler with strange habits?
The man of whom I speak is called Pizer or Pyther, a man with a frightening face. Do you know him?
Yes, John Pizer. He worked here for a while, but he is no longer here.
Do you know where I can find him?
No, and if you look, you will not find him.
Why?
Because he is in hiding, Doctor. You see, a week ago, a horrible murder took place in the neighborhood. A rumor circulated that he might have been responsible for this crime. They say he has quarreled with women of certain virtue in the past, if you understand me.
Isaac, it is about the Bucks Road case that I have come to see you. I have the certitude and an incontestable witness that Pizer is innocent, at least of this crime, although he has attacked a number of street women. If he doesn't come forward to explain himself to the authorities, he is condemned to hiding and to take the fall for this murder. Furthermore, it will cast suspicions on your community because they must be hiding him. And while the whole police force is hunting for him, they cannot concentrate on the real assassin who roams the streets and, one never knows, may take any one of you any day.
If what you say is true, your visit is a godsend to our community, Doctor. I tell you something. I know Sergeant Thick, an honest policeman who lives in the area. I'll tell John's family that he must go there to explain himself. But if you could please go as soon as possible to the police to give them this report that you say is incontestable.
I will go as soon as I take leave of you.
Thank you. If I can ever be of service in any way, do not hesitate to ask.
Could we transform your horse harnesses into harnesses for wooden legs? Adjustable harnesses.
A good craftsman can do anything, Doctor. And I do believe that's what I am. Come back in a while and it will be done. That will be my thanks for what you have done.
I shall return later.
At your convenience, sir.
Ah, I am spent. I would like to return home. But I promised to go to the police as soon as I could. Now then, let's go to the police station.
All right, let's get out of here. Can I just teleport? I shouldn't even could have done this. Hold on. Boom. Oh, okay. Load. Oh, another murder.
Will you?
Yes.
Oh, about to get it on. Oh.
Hey, Doctor, you seem tired. Were you wandering the darker parts of Whitechapel all night?
You could say that. I have some information on Leather Apron, the man of whom we spoke earlier.
Do you know where he is?
No, but I can clear him of the Buck's Row crime. A witness proved him totally innocent.
Oh, Watson, Watson, is it only now, after many hours of walking, that you decide to pass on the important message that Inspector Abberline is waiting for?
But, no. But what are you doing here, Holmes?
I was worried, Watson, and with good reason, it would appear. Go give the message to this policeman and let's go home. Nobody appreciates me hanging around here, you know, and it's freezing cold.
Ah, Creddle, none too soon. You will take the testimony of this.
No, you continue with your duty shift. I must find Chandler in Ambry Street. He's struck again.
Who?
The murderer, the Buck's Row assassin.
Hanbury Street. Let's go, Watson. We have no time to lose.
Hanbury Street? Okay.
Hanbury Street. Let's go, Watson. We have no time to lose.
That's probably what incident happened. Yup. Yup. Definitely an incident happened here.
Mr. Sherlock Holmes.
I don't want to talk to these people. Let's talk to them.
You can go in, Mr. Holmes. She's there. We didn't touch a thing.
I ain't talking to me. What? Okay, Watson. Watson.
What are we doing, Holmes?
What do you think? Is a murder happened? Dude, I cannot see. Alright, you know what? I'm sorry, but I gotta literally... Let me see if I can actually turn up the brightness in this shit. You can't even do that. It's stupid. This game fucking sucks. God fucking damn it. Yup. Cha 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 cha.
It was very good of PC Chandler to let us pass. He said no one has touched the corpse. It's the perfect opportunity for us to put our skills to the test. Watson, let's not waste it.
Wait, what am I doing? Oh, this again? Okay.
Bloodstains on the wall.
Oh, this again. Oh my god.
The blood is a dozen inches or so from the ground. A piece of coarse muslin. Two combs, curiously arranged. There are no trails on the ground. There's no sign of a struggle.
A piece of envelope found. Can I open it? Oh, that's it.
A torn envelope. It smells of rubbing alcohol. It contains three pills. I will take one.
Xanax?
Two should suffice for the police.
Oh! Xanax? Ecstasy? Alright, go to the middle, please. Go to the middle, please. Thank you.
So, Doctor, shall we examine our victim?
Ah, I'm tired, Holmes. I'm not sure if I am in a state to do this work.
Come, Watson, there is little time. Show me what you're made of.
Oh, my God.
Pray, Watson, pull yourself together. Can you establish the time of the crime?
Yesterday.
The extremities of the corpse are cold and rigor mortis is beginning to set in. I would say that the murder was committed over 2 hours ago, before 4:30 a.m.
Oh, what the fuck?
Now, let's look at the stomach, or at least what remains of it.
It's dreadful, Holmes. Who could do that to someone?
That's what you're here for, Watson. Tell me what this man has done.
The stomach has been entirely opened and... Oh, my God! A number of organs have been removed.
Ugh. So, you're telling me that the organs were removed, Watson. They weren't ripped out.
Not at all, Holmes. On the contrary, this is clearly the work of an expert. I couldn't have done any better myself. And the uterus is missing.
Oh, what the fuck? Oh my gosh.
Looky here. It would seem he has a mark on his left hand.
Wait, take? Take what?
The victim must have worn a large ring or several little ones, and someone pulled them off forcefully. This detail will be very valuable, Watson. You can be sure of that.
Is that it? What else? Might be something else. Okay, I guess. Get the middle. Okay.
Let's look at this poor woman more closely.
See the neck.
Look at her neck. What can you tell me?
There are two incisions.
Swollen lips.
The tongue is swollen.
Got punched in the face.
A bruise. The victim's face appears to have bruising, wouldn't you say?
Under the maxilla and cheek. There is less on the right side.
My dear Watson, now that we have found all of our clues, nothing remains but to subject them to our most likely hypotheses in order to deduce the facts.
Put them all there and then try to figure it out. The victim had her throat slit while lying down, still alive. The victim had her throat slit while standing up. Probably already dead. The killer blurred the traces. It wasn't dragged. Murderer held the victim's chin with his right hand. I'm gonna figure this out myself. Isn't like the same thing as... Maybe. Maybe it's the right hand. This is, I'll pick the first one. Ah. I guess the only way for me to answer these questions. When it hits green, I'm right. Alright, let's do this. One, two. Best way to answer these questions. Oh my god, this is so confusing. Oh, there's more. I'm about to cheat on this shit. Oh my god, how am I supposed to know this? So I apparently got this right. Okay, I don't even know. I'm about to cheat. So, victim wasn't dragged. Slicer was still alive. Think I got this one right. Okay. Going so fast. Okay. Was eaten. Oh my god. Right.
I hear a noise coming from the street, Watson. The authorities are arriving. It's time for us to go.
Holmes has been locked away in his room for days, always saying the same things. I'm thinking, Watson. Very good, Watson. As you wish, Watson. But I am thinking too, so much so that I can't sleep. Annie Chapman, good Lord.
What am I supposed to do? knock on his door?
Treaty on Cornish, the Celtic dialect of Cornwall. And here, medieval pottery. How can Holmes possibly read such things? Colonel Gordon, during the last adventure of the resident patient.
I don't think I've seen all this stuff yet, so let me just check this out.
Holmes uses this old Persian slipper to hold his pipe tobacco. Switzerland, a charming country. Perhaps Holmes and I shall investigate one day. This is how Holmes stores his post. Thank goodness his clients don't see this.
Aha! Uh-huh. Wow.
This is the coal bucket in which Holmes keeps his cigars. What a funny idea. This is the harpoon that pierced the sailor Peter the Black. Bizarre little relic. Holmes examined the broken jar that belonged to Finlay's tenant. I wonder what this substance is. I don't recognize the odor.
Formalin, Watson. This jar contained formalin. Interesting, don't you think? I've been waiting for something for days. Just the tiniest bit of news that would make sense of this whole matter. But there's nothing, neither from the press nor the police. Unless Inspector Abberline is holding on to some information without realizing its importance, which is quite possible. It is time for you to return to the police station in Whitechapel, Watson. And didn't you tell me that you had a matter to take care of it? Take advantage of it to learn more about this pill and its contents.
Ah, but Holmes, it's late. And spending another night in this district is hardly my idea of entertainment.
I know, Doctor, but we don't have any choice. Time is against us. Take your pistol in case you run into any troublesome characters.
Fine, oh, as you wish, Holmes.
Nice, I get to shoot. Well, hold on. Can I check around before I go? Is there anything else? I think that was it. Alright.
Good evening. I hope I'm not disturbing you.
Not at all, Doctor. This man, Mr. Richardson, is a witness to the horrid affair at 29 Hanbury Street, the murder of Annie Chapman. We are discussing the relevance of his testimony.
You're probably not in a position to discuss it with me, but I would like to know more about what you call the relevance of this young man's testimony.
Oh, there's no secrecy. It's simply that the testimony given by Mr. Richardson doesn't match the time of death given by the coroner, Dr. Phillips.
What was the time of death, according to him?
Before 4:30 in the morning.
My conclusions were the same. Were there any other conflicting testimonies?
Well, two other witnesses summoned at the preliminary inquest gave testimony, but in these cases too, the times don't match.
Do you remember what it was they said?
I didn't question them myself. A colleague of mine took down their statements on paper, but on deciding they were of little use, he tore them up and threw them in the bin. There's no point in being bogged down with useless paperwork.
I will take my leave, Humphreys.
Goodbye, Doctor.
May I introduce myself? I'm Dr. Watson. I am...
You wouldn't be the chap what writes the detective stories in that there paper.
Well, yes, indeed, my stories have been published in the Strand.
Go blimey, wanna tell me old mum?
It would seem your testimony is the subject of some debate. Could you tell me what it was about?
Don't be telling you I'm a bit befuddled about the times that I told them. But it can't be so. I knows what I sees and what I don't sees that morning.
What did you see, or what didn't you see? And at what time, would you say?
I'll tell you this for nothing. It's me old mum who lives at the house where the body was found out back in the garden. She has her shop at the bottom to the right of the stairs. Her door was broken down not too far back, because it's a real zoo, it is. Right, the morning it happened, I head that way to see if my old mum has finally had the place broken into. It was 4:45 when I got there. That, I'll swear on me dear old mum's life. I had a look round to see if the cellar had been taken. No. I had a little sit down on the stairs by the courtyard, because my shoes were causing me no end of pain, and I had a cut and all. I didn't see a single thing below the steps, Doctor. Not one single thing. If there was some bird all covered in blood, tain't no how I could have missed that, even if it were night time. Right. 5 minutes after getting to number 29, I had to clip off. And now they tells me that either I can't tell time no more, or I was fixing me loafer next to a stiff that was still steaming. All right, then. Evening, gents.
Good evening, Mr. Solomonovich.
Good evening, Doctor. What a pleasure to see you again.
Have you finished converting the harnesses?
Yes, just now. I got a little behind because of all the commotion.
Commotion?
Don't you start. 3 days ago, the very afternoon that you passed by, there was a chase throughout the neighborhood. Hundreds of people were chasing one man, claiming he was responsible for the murders these last few days. Schmontz! It was awful. I hope those maniacs didn't catch him. Better the police should.
Tell me, did John Pizer turn himself in to the police?
Things unfolded as they should. Look in the newspaper, the Daily News from today.
Farewell, Isaac.
Goodbye, Doctor.
Oh, okay. There's a good reason why the public acceptance of the maniac theory should be endorsed and encouraged. At present, there is real danger in Whitechapel of turning opinion in quite another direction. Improbable rumors contain the worst elements of fantasy, where inciting a hatred of Jews more abhorrent than that which is caused by religious fanaticism. Following the police for an investigation into the circumstances surrounding the murder of Annie Chapman in Whitechapel, several men were arrested yesterday, among whom a Polish Jew named Pizer, a Brandon not far from the scene of the crime. Pizer was released last evening. Oh, he just got out. Wow. All right. So we go to clinic. Oh, I had it. Give this to him.
Good evening, Dr. Gibbons.
Dr. Watson.
Did you keep the cane we spoke of last time?
I was going to sell it tomorrow, would you believe, having not heard word.
Here are your harnesses, Doctor.
They are top quality, I'd say. Definitely worth the price of this walking stick. Here, it's yours.
Do you have any formalin here?
No, definitely not. They have it in university hospitals to conserve anatomical specimens in jars. But in a little clinic like mine, we don't keep anything but bad memories.
Well, farewell, Doctor.
Goodbye, Dr. Watson.
I must go to Miss Bella's.
I got a Bella's, okay. How do I... Ah! I think it's right there. There's only one person? Okay, I guess I gotta talk to him.
Good evening, ma'am. Your door was open. Isn't that a little dangerous?
Hello, Doctor. Don't worry, if the looks of anyone who enters doesn't please me, me and my pistol know how to convince them to leave.
Damn, okay.
Do you happen to know Annie Chapman, the poor woman who was killed 3 days ago?
Dark Annie? Like all the drifters in the area, I've seen her once or twice. With respect to the dead, Annie really was the bottom of the barrel.
What do you mean?
Well, in our profession, the pretty young ones go out when night has barely fallen and don't have a problem finding takers. But poor girls like Annie or Polly Nichols, who aren't as tender and are often sick, sometimes trudge around for a whole night in the cold and the rain before landing a client. And that doesn't help their appearances either. They don't have much choice about paying for a bed for a few hours, a glass of gin or a hot meal.
How terribly sad.
That's the price of survival in Whitechapel, my angel. One of our girls knew Annie for some time. They bought some jewellery on the black market, I think.
Jewellery? How could Annie Chapman have possibly afforded jewellery?
Luxuries for a woman are always relative to her condition, Doctor. As a matter of fact, it was real cheap junk. Annie got 3 assorted brass rings, I think. It's been said I have a memory for jewellery.
How is Lucy keeping?
She's doing well, Doctor. But believe me, it won't last. Rare are the girls who can build a future in our profession.
Very well. I shall let you get back to work, Mark.
See you soon, my love.
Okay, what else is there to do?
Best not to stray off in that direction.
What else can I check here?
Best not to stray off in that direction. Best not to stray off in that direction.
Oh my gosh. Can't go over there. Muscles go now. I guess police station? I don't know. I'll just go there and see. So I really don't know where to go.
Yes, Doctor?
Here we go.
So, how far along are the investigations into these 2 recent murders?
Everyone around here believes both crimes were committed by the same man. But as for the Hanbury Street and Bucks Row crimes, nobody has heard or seen a thing.
By the way, have you heard of a Dr. Tumblety?
No. Is it important?
Yes. Well, no, maybe. Actually, I don't know. I have heard about this man, his frequent nocturnal outings and bizarre behaviour.
What does this chap look like, Doctor? And where can we find him?
The last I heard was that he was staying at Finlay's place, the man who was looking for me a few days ago.
It would greatly assist us if you could ask Finlay what your strange associate looks like. We could then see if the description matches any witness accounts.
All right, guess we're going to see Finlay.
I will take my leave, Humphreys.
Goodbye, Doctor.
All right.
There is a strong smell of gas. It seems to be coming from the abandoned building.
Guess we'll talk to you, figure out what's going
on. Good evening, Finlay. How are you?
Oh, good evening, Doctor. So-so. And you?
It smells of gas here.
Ah, you might say, Doctor. Without wanting to speak ill of the force, I have to wonder if the police are up to something.
What do you mean?
Well, I was outside yesterday evening when the light went out at my place, and a gas smell came from the abandoned building across from my place. And a minute later, the police arrived and were snooping all around like it was them who hit the gas before arriving.
Have things sorted themselves out with your strange tenant?
Don't talk about it, Doctor. That man is truly bizarre. He goes to the most sordid locations once night falls. 3 days ago, my wife told me she saw him come in with blood-stained clothes and a fearsome look.
Interesting. What does he look like, and how old is he?
Oh, he's my age, give or take. So, the other side of 50. He's always dressed in a striking manner, with an American hat. He's big, close to 5'11", I'd say. He has a strange voice, not just his accent, see? His voice.
Pretty well. Goodbye for now, Finley.
Goodbye, Doctor.
Now then, let's go to the police station.
Not great.
Yes, Doctor.
Tumblety's a man around 5'11", about 55 years old, extravagantly dressed and with a rather distinctive voice. He boards at Finley's. You should know where that is, as the police were there only yesterday. Their arrival coincided with a strange gas leak.
Ah, yes, I know where you mean. Indeed, there was an odd affair with the gas. It was rather unsettling. We were searching for a well-known scoundrel who was ratted out by Squibby, the chap we followed and saved from the pack a few days ago. This thug, no pity Bluto, must have been in the abandoned building in question. But there was no sign of him when we arrived. Furthermore, an inspector said that, given the smell, the thingamabob that supplies gas to the building was probably damaged. So we took no risks and were called away somewhere else.
I will take my leave, Humphreys.
Goodbye, Doctor.
Okay, so where do I go now? Can I just go into the room? Oh, can I actually do that? No, I can't.
There is a strong smell of gas. It seems to be coming from the abandoned building.
You about that, please?
Anything else, Doctor?
Oh my god.
Pretty well.
Good.
So, what do I do from here? Yeah, I already checked that. I guess go to the police station. Is there a door here? No? Alright, let's try the police station again. I don't know if that will tell him about the gas. Let me see.
Yes, Doctor.
Nope.
I will take my leave.
Goodbye, Doctor.
Closed.
Oh. April 1886. Armored tag at the White Plume Mountain Inn, also called the Kayak Affair, 5 years to honor. Jacob Levy, 30 years old. Allgate theft of weight of meat from his employer, Heyman Samson Butcher, 58. Solson Street, Whitechapel, 20 months. Essex County Asylum, James. Longfoot Jim knows they're 20 years old. Whitechapel attack on a nun. Okay.
An old report on arrests that took place a few years earlier.
What?
Here are the ripped
statements. God.
I can piece them together again.
Jesus Christ. Oh, why did I do that?
Okay. Here are the ripped statements. I can piece them together again.
Ah, shit. I'm not gonna do this. Okay, it's probably easy. Something like that. Oh, okay. Let's just put it there. When am I supposed to... Okay, how am I supposed to organize this? Oh my god. This is complicated. Alright, let me do that real quick. Before I do that, I'm gonna go back to that place.
I have no reason to
go
that
way. Oh, come
on.
Yay. Alright. Where did he go there from? Things like this, turn left. I don't know how he get there, but I want to go there. Maybe it's that door. Maybe it's this. Ah! See, you want to tell me this.
The Wasp's Nest. This pub looks even more disreputable than the Golden Lion in Baker Street. I have no reason to go that way.
Ay, ay, ay. I gotta do that paper thing. The fuck? For now, how the fuck am I supposed to solve this? This was super impossible. Alright, got it.
Jeez. There, all done. Holmes couldn't have done better himself.
Patient. Yeah, definitely patient. Jesus Christ.